Well, we were down at Bishop at the Bishop Mule days here this last spring. Kind of got a kick out of this mule. I think his mother must have been a giraffe. Well, anyway, we've been talking about these Sarven hubs, and most of them take a quarter inch round head rivet, while a few of them do take 5/16. So I'm going to check quick and see which one we want. Kind of looks like the quarter's going to be too small. I think we're going to end up going with the 5/16. Thank you. Well, this is the basic design of the 1857 patented Sarven hub. It has the flanges up the face of the spokes. It really adds a lot of strength in the dish direction. And also each spoke shoulders up one to another, so it has a lot of side support. So overall, this is a pretty strong hub. Well, today, this basic style of the Sarven hub is still being used, except it's been adapted without any hub core, and it's designed to use with roller bearings. The casting is much heavier, therefore it's machined instead of just a raw cast like the flanges on the old style Sarven. And also has a dust cap, which helps keep the dirt out of the Timken roller bearings. Actually, the Timken roller bearing initiated in the buggy era. So anyway, this is the style of Sarven hub that is most commonly used today because of the desire for roller bearings. Now they go together basically the same as a wood core hub does. The tenons on the spokes are going to fit inside these cast mortises, and it's just a matter of getting them fitted up. A regular style Sarven spoke actually has a tenon that's a bit too long, and there are specialty made spokes that just fit these, but I just stock the standard Sarvens. The tenons are a little long, but we're going to make them fit. Now I've got an order for two of these wheels to go onto a cart, and it always takes a little longer on the first hub to kind of get the pattern figured out. But once we do, the second one picks up and is a whole lot more efficient time-wise. And normally, because I've done so many of these, I don't go through this step, but I'm going to go through it just so you can kind of see how the old style Sarven spoke really doesn't fit. And sometimes the factory angles aren't really too accurate. So this is kind of how the process goes, even though in reality I skip quite a few of these steps. So you can kind of see the basic style is still there, just with the advantage of some modern conveniences. So now when you watch those old westerns, you'll kind of know what to watch for. Once again, thanks for watching.